All right, so I'm writing this blog post and I'm gonna share a video with a few examples. So Stripe payment links, the first step is that you have your product here and you go to after payment. So here, instead of show confirmation page, you're gonna don't show confirmation page, and instead you're gonna redirect visitors to a thank you page, and you're going to add this checkout session ID as a URL parameter. Now, with a setup as simple as this, you can pretty much start conversion tracking just by adding a little JavaScript snippet to your website, which is going to look for this checkout session ID. And whenever there is a checkout session ID, which of course only happens with these Stripe redirects, you can get the value, the checkout session ID, the Stripe session ID, which is a unique identifier, which can be used as a transaction ID for Google Ads and Google Analytics. So to get a unique ID, for example, in Google Tag Manager for a Google Ads conversion or a Meta Pixel conversion, we want to have a transaction ID, because people may refresh this page and we don't want duplicates. We can just use this convenient Stripe checkout session ID from the URL. Now, we can take this a little bit further by adding the value into the URL. So here, we could just manually go and add @value is 100. And now we can run a script like this. And we can get the transaction ID, which is the Stripe checkout session ID thing. And we can get the value. And now we can push these to the data layer in Google Tag Manager and fire all our tracking script. So we can actually check what the data layer consists of. And we can see a purchase event here with an e-commerce event. I've hard-coded the currency here, assuming it's going to be the same for everyone, because we want as few of these manual variables as possible. So this is a setup that I would do if you had like one product with a fairly consistent price and you just need Stripe conversion tracking set up in like a couple of hours. However, this is not a kind of like a professional setup that would work if you have multiple products and if you want like proper tracking, including enhanced conversion tracking and Metapixel advanced matching and things like that. But yeah, I demonstrated this because this is the starting point from where you can take it a little further. All right, so if you want to then take it to a more advanced level, you can create something like a make.com intermediary. So the way this works is that on your thank you page here, we would have a JavaScript fetch. So it's going to send a request to a webhook. So this webhook would be something we would set up in make.com, for example. So we would send the Stripe checkout session ID via the JavaScript fetch into this webhook. And then this webhook is going to go and ask Stripe for information about this purchase. So we can fire this step. And here we can see the data. This is just a test purchase with like my test email. But yeah, I'm not going to go opening this up. Well, maybe tax IDs, shipping options, etc. All right, so I had used a test Seppo Taalasma with a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Anyway, you can see that you get all the information, you get the purchase, you get the, I think you can even get the name of this product. So let's say that we have a test product and we have, you know, 20 different ones. You can get which product was purchased for a real e-commerce tracking. And indeed, you can use the name, phone, email, etc. for enhanced conversion tracking, etc. So this API HTTP request call is going to then answer to the webhook on your thank you page here. So here we would ask for this information. All right, I had to pause the video for a moment to create some JavaScript to make a demo and make sure that I'm not sharing anything sensitive. Well, it doesn't matter. This is a test account anyway, and I'm not sharing any API keys. So I think this is going to be not a problem. So for all you hackers out there, feel free to do anything with this. So now we have the make.com automation running. So now we can kind of demonstrate. Let's say that we are at the thank you page here. And now we want to get the information out of this Stripe payment so we can do more accurate dynamic automatic conversion tracking. So I'm gonna hit send. Sorry, that was the wrong function. Here is the simplified version. So just gonna use a test Stripe checkout session. So here the idea is that now we get all this information about this booking, including you can see the customer details like the email name, phone number, even the tax exemption, currencies, all this stuff. And now we can populate our data layer and custom event triggers based on this reply from tool like make.com or n8n.com. So here it gets the webhook request, it gets the Stripe info. So this is pretty safe because, you know, hackers can't really do much here. If you know better, let me know. But I think the idea is that you need the checkout session key to be able to fetch, and this will not do anything else except return information about this unique purchase. And then it's just going to respond to the webhook here, which is this thing. All right, hope this was helpful. Also, feel free to get in touch for easier, more advanced, and much simpler tracking systems. I'm both developing these myself, implementing these for my clients, running setups for them. So if you're not that interested in dealing with errors like this every day of your life and all these problems, then we have easier ways to go around it. But I am also going to be collaborating with some companies who implement Stripe payment link tracking using kind of their customized apps. So get in touch and we'll sort you out with the setup that's best for you. All right, thanks for watching, and let me know how it goes.